Good morning. Another day in paradise.
Please don't make small talk with me when we both know you're here because of the ship.
I am. You're still trying to prove me wrong, aren't you?
You are wrong.
The human race is perverted by war and endless misery. All they do is come, fight, destroy and corrupt one another. It always ends the same way.
Wrong! It only ends once. Anything that happens before that, well, that's just progress.
Do you have any idea how badly I want to kill you?
Yes.
One of these days, sooner or later, I will find a loophole, my friend, and your blood will drip from my blade.
Well, you know where to find me. I'm not going anywhere.
Always nice talking to you, Doctor.
Taking the time to answer a couple of questions. First of all, what was your reaction when you saw or when you read the first 42 pages of the script?
Oh, well, to be absolutely honest, I thought, bloody hell, have I got enough ink in my printer? Joking apart, I thought it was great. So much work I've gone into. Let's see what's going on.
And what do you love most about what you've read so far?
It's a very intriguing story. I like it, and I quite like its pace. It's a bit slower than we're used to, but then being an old fuddy-duddy, I quite enjoy that. I do like the idea that you've got this whole mixture of Star Trek and Star Wars and Doctor Who. Very intriguing indeed.
So, Secrets of Earth, Episode 1, saw the return of the series. What was your reaction to what you saw?
Well, as I say, I was very chuffed to be asked to sort of take part, and I thought, well, I can't wait to get going.
Now, I've stated that many scenes are being kept quiet until the very last minute, so do you have any idea, just from seeing episode one, where we're going?
No, I have no idea, and I want it kept that way. Thank you very much. I just love the idea of being puzzled, so I can go away and think about it, and then see if what I've thought about is actually going to happen. No, I very much like that idea.
The two Time Lords that we see at the beginning, what are your thoughts about their relationship?
Yes, it's so easy with these sort of things just to think very black and white, literally, and just say it's goody and baddie. I quite like the idea that they might be brothers or cousins. Think on that, right?
Ooh. So, what's it like then working with me?
It's all been down the line so far. So, no, it's been an absolute pleasure. And Kieran, you give a very good direction. So it was very straightforward for me to do what you asked.
Does this feel original to you?
Does it feel original? Yes, it does. The actual look of it is very unusual, but very pleasing. I think it is. It is original.
Okay. I've stated many times that the sequel to Secrets will be a Titanic story called Peril on the Sea. So, just by hearing that title, what are your thoughts?
All I would say is try not to make it the Poseidon adventure, and just remember the Titanic story is actually a true story. So just keep that in mind, otherwise it would be a good idea. I'm not sure that it will be too much of an issue, but
I've stated many times, especially over the past few months, that they're going to be the last stories I'm ever going to do. Do you think that's necessarily a good or a bad thing?
Well, there's the old adage, you know, quit whilst you're high, but I would always say never say never. You know, keep things on hold. But what I've seen so far is very good. And if not Secrets of Earth, something very similar I think you should keep out, because you do it extremely well.
To your character that we see at the beginning of Secrets of Earth Episode 1, the Time Lord in White, how much input did you have on that character?
The only input is just to think about the actual voice I'm going to use. I mean, Kieran has explained what he'd like me to do, and I try and do it as best I can. And what I would say, though, is having seen it, Kieran, you asked me to be an old character with a weak voice. I'm supposed to be thousands of years old. And yet, when I visually see the character, he's a nimble 28-year-old. So that was a bit odd to see, but I think it does work. It'll be interesting, as I say, to see what other people think.
And can you tell us any more about your character?
All right. Well, I think it's best that I keep that to myself.
What can we expect from episode 2?
I would imagine a greater development of the story, but all very, very exciting. Very exciting indeed. So, just watch this space.
Do you feel that I'm creating something that will be referred to for years to come, or do you think it's, it's just going to last a couple of moments?
I think you'll find that there will be some sort of following, and yes, there's a strong possibility, as once the story has developed more. Yes, I think there's a good chance that it'll stay in the annals of sci-fi, and that's the main reason why I'm really interested in the project.
So when you were asked to do this project, what attracted you most about it?
I liked the look of what was produced, and to be honest, I was asked. and once I was asked, I always considered that an honour and a privilege to be asked by people. And so what attracted to me, if I'm absolutely honest, was the chance of doing more work. Two, helping some people out on a project that they're working on, and three, I just liked it.
What do you hate so much about the script?
I can't say that I hate the script at all. No, it's absolutely fine as far as I'm concerned.
What are you looking forward to most out of the trilogy?
The story development, I think. And seeing people's reaction to each episode as it comes out. Because, episode 1 was clearly very much an introduction to things. But as the story unfolds, I think more and more people get involved. So that's what I...
What would you like to see more of?
Well, as any performer and actor and musician would say, the thing that they want to see more of is me! Bye for now.
Well, thank you, Simon. It's been a pleasure. Thank you.